This is what we're going to study today. We're going to be talking about Gega, Aja, and Kibikuse. 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 And then we're going to look at the time. We're going to look at almost Gega, Aja, and then we're going to look at Kibikuse. 58. In this session, we're gonna learn how to ask a question, answer a question. What time is it? It is almost 9 o'clock. It is 9 o'clock, and it is past 9 o'clock. Let's begin session 28. There's three words that you gotta know when you're talking about the time of day. First word is Gega. Gega means almost. It is almost time. When someone asks you a question, Anin minikeje seg, you answer either with Gega, or you answer with Aja, or you answer with Kibikuse. Kibikuse. Okay, so remember those three words, Gega, Aja, and Kibikuse. Kibikuse. Okay, let's say someone comes up to you and asks you the question, Anin minikeje seg. Let's start with this example first, Gega. Someone asks you, Anin minikeje seg. You're going to say, and let's say the time was somewhere around here, around this time. Let's say it was 8:45. And you'd say, and someone asks you, Anin minikeje seg? You would say, Gega shangaswe ijise. You would use that word first. Gega shangaswe ijise. Can you say that? Gega shangaswe ijise. Next word is Aja. Aja signals when it is exactly on time. So you, in order to say it is 9 o'clock, if someone asked you, Anin minikeje seg, you would say, Aja shangaswe ijise. Can you say it too? Aja shangaswe ijise. Right on, good job. That's how you say it is 9 o'clock. Do you remember the third word we introduced in session 28? Well, let me tell you. It's a big long word, and it's Kibikuse. Kibikuse. And that signals that it's already past the hour. So let's say someone asked you once more, Anin minikeje seg? You would turn to them and you would say, upon looking at the clock, you would say, Aja shangaswe Kibikuse. It is already past 9 p.m. or 9 a.m. Okay, so you remember those three words? Let's take a look at those three words once more. Three words, when someone asks you, Anin minik eje seg, you would answer with Gega shangaswe ijise, if that's just before 9 p.m. or 9 a.m. And then if they asked you once again, Anin minikeje seg, you would say Aja shangaswe ijise. And if it was just past 9 p.m. or 9 a.m. and they asked you, Anin minikeje seg, you would answer Aja shangaswe Kibikuse. Okay, so let's do a test here. Are you ready? Let's say I asked you this one. Can you hear me? Anin minik eje seg. Anin minik eje seg. Haninminikejisig. Did you say Aja Shangaswe Ijise? And if you did, good job. What about if it's just before 9? Let's say that the hand was right there and someone asks you, Haninminikejisig. You would say Gega Shangaswe Ijise. One more time. Gega Shangaswe Ijise. Let's try the final one. Then we'll be done. Let's say it was this time on the wall. And someone asks you, Anin Minikejiseg. You would say Shangaswe Gibikuse Ijise. Shangaswe Kibikuse Ijise. Alright, that concludes our lesson plan for today. Learning outcome is to be able to tell time just before 9 and then at 9 and then just past 9. Stay tuned. When we come back, we'll take a look at how to say just before 10 p.m., 10 p.m., and just after 10 p.m. Stay tuned. We'll be right back. Session 29, 10 p.m. Our learning outcome will be to ask a question, answer a question. What time is it? It is almost 10 p.m. It is 10 p.m. and it is past 10 p.m. Let us begin. There's three words that you gotta know when you're answering the question, Anin Minik Ejiseg. Your first word for session 29 is this. Gega means it is almost at the top of the hour. It is almost at the top of the hour. Second word is when it is at the top of the hour, when it is already at a solid number, let's say 10 p.m., this is the word you would use. Aja. Aja. And finally, if it's just after 10 p.m., you would say Gabikuse. Gabikuse. Now remember, the number 10 is Mitaswe. Mitaswe. So let's take a look at the clock. Okay. Mitaswe. Mitaswe. That's the time we're going to look for. Okay, let's take a look at three possible scenarios. Let's say it was almost 10 p.m. Let's say it was right about there. You can tell that it's almost 10 o'clock. It's almost to the 12. And so you would say Gega Mitaswe Ijise. You would use that first word. Remember that first word? Gega. And then you'd use Mitaswe. And to signal clock, Ijise, where it occurs. Either here, here, or eventually right here. Okay, so that is the phrase for that one is Gega. So if I asked you, Anin Minikejiseg, you would turn to me and say, Gega Mitaswe Ijise. Can you say that? Gega Mitaswe Ijise. Good job, good job. Oh my goodness, you're getting the hang of this. Okay, let's move forward. How about this one? How about if the clock went up to here. It is now 10 o'clock. So how would you say that? Well, remember what I told you? You could say Aja. So you take the first word, which is Mitaswe. Mitaswe. Oh yeah, no, for sure. Excuse me, you would say Yes, you'd say mitaswe. Excuse me, you'd say aja. Aja. Mitaswe. Et je sais. Aja mitaswe et je sais. Can you say that? Aja mitaswe et je sais. Good job. What if the hand was here? Well, that would be after 10 p.m. Right? Okay. Again, let's start from the top. Someone would ask you, Anin minik ejiseg? And you would answer, mitaswe. You would say, mitaswe. Excuse me. You would say, 10 o'clock. Mitaswe. Kibikuse. Et je sais. There you go. One more time. Mitaswe. Kibikuse. Et je sais. Good job. Okay, let's do a test. Let's see if you understand that so far. Anin minik ejiseg? Kega mitaswe ejise. Anin minik ejiseg? Aja mitaswe ejise. Anin minik ejiseg? Kibikuse shangaswe. Et je sais. Good job. All right, well, that takes us up to 10 p.m. or just slightly after 10 p.m. Come back and join me, Corey the Coyote, and we'll finish the remainder of the clock in session.